Hey guys, it's me Rahul, and this is a video that I wanted to do for a very long time. Finally got time to do it, so without further ado, let's begin. The reason why I decided to make a video like this is that I absolutely love customizing and turning an old phone at least to an usable one. So before we get started, make sure that your device is rooted and has a custom recovery installed on it. If you haven't done any of that, go ahead and do it. I cannot exactly explain how to root and install custom recovery because the procedures differ based on the device that you're using. If you are too scared to root your device, then check the description down below. There will be a timestamp. Click on that. It will skip this video to a part where I explain a way to stop apps from running in the background on non-rooted devices. There are multiple ways to improve the performance of an old device. I will explain all of them in this video. One of the main reasons why an old device becomes so laggy and slow is because of the bloatware apps that comes with it. Most of these apps are not useful at all, so first we need to get rid of them. The app that I strongly recommend is System App Remover. It is an awesome app to remove system apps and batch uninstall applications. So install the app from the link in the description, then open it and select all the bloatware apps and click on uninstall and wait for a couple of minutes. After you're done doing all that, just restart your device. You might immediately notice a small, if not significant, improvement in the performance. Okay, that is just one of the simple things that we are doing. Now we are moving on to the next stage. Now you have removed all the unwanted apps, but what if the app that potentially making your phone slow is an app that you use on a regular basis? Then there is a way to fix that. What we are going to be basically doing is force stopping that app from running in the background, so that way that particular app won't use any resources such as memory and CPU. There are of course dozens of apps out there which can do that for you. I will leave links to at least three in the description down below. An app that I'm using for a very long time is Greenify. It is a popular app among root users. It has a very simple UI and it works really well. Not only these apps improve the performance of a device, but it also saves some juice too. I don't recommend force stopping an app that you use very frequently because that app has to load in every bit of data it needs back into memory again to open up, which will take a bit of time and makes your phone's performance even worse. So use Greenify on apps that you don't use that often. Another app that I recommend is ShutUp. This app doesn't require root access, but it takes a lot of time to force stop applications. But if you are using Greenify, it does it in seconds. Another app that I'm using for a couple of months is Icebox. Besides stopping apps from running in the background, it will also hide the apps that you have selected from the launcher as well. I don't recommend you to use all of the apps that I mentioned at once. Just use one because that's pretty much all you need. And also don't use any of those fake battery saver apps because, to be honest, they all are trash and it makes your phone's performance even worse. So please don't use those battery saver apps. There is an app called XPOSED installer. You can use it with Greenify to unlock more features. Installing XPOSED installer onto your phone can be a pretty tough job if you have no experience with root apps. So I will leave a link to the tutorial in the description. So if you have any doubt regarding that, check it out. Talking of XPOSED installer, there is another awesome app that you can use with XPOSED installer to save some juice. The app is called Amplify. You can download it for free from the XPOSED installer app. So Amplify is an app that puts applications to sleep. The simple way to explain what exactly this app does is to consider a situation like this. You locked and put away your phone and then there is an app trying to wake it up. Let's say that app wants to send a notification alert. If you have enabled Amplify, then Amplify would say, "No, you cannot wake up the phone right now. I will let you send this alert another time." So that is basically what Amplify does. It is very similar to the DOS feature in Android. The app is a bit difficult to use, but once you get a hang of it, it's pretty easy. You can also use Majest Modes to kind of do the same things. But for this video, I'm assuming you are using an older device. So I'm going to be talking about some modes that works on older versions of Android. That is why I'm using XPOSED installer. Okay, now I have covered all the things that you can do with apps. So now we are moving on to the next stage in which we are going to be dealing with custom ROMs and custom kernels. Before that, let's look at what is a ROM and a kernel is. ROM, a file containing the executable instruction, a system image of an Android OS and affiliated apps. Kernel, it is the central part of an operating system. It manages the task of the computer and the hardware, most notably memory and CPU type. Those are very simple explanations. Now you got a basic idea about ROM and kernel, let's see how it affects the performance of a device. ROM is basically the operating system that manages all the files and operations. ROM also manages the user interface, which plays a big role in the experience that you get out of a phone. User interfaces can sometimes make your phone laggy even if your device has top-of-the-line specs. The kernel, on the other hand, is a piece of software which manages memory access for apps. You can think of kernel as a link between your software and the hardware. It is one of the core components of an OS. It also plays a big role in the overall performance of a device because kernel deals with the memory management and communication. If I explain more, it is going to sound even more complicated, so I'm not going to do that. The last thing that you can do to improve the performance of a device is by flashing a custom ROM and a custom kernel onto the device. It might sound pretty complicated, but it is actually very simple. The ROM that comes with the phone that is pre-installed on your device by companies is called a stock ROM. One of the main problems with these stock ROMs is that the companies will add skins and some features on top of original Android to make it look more appealing. In return of these modifications, the software part of a device will perform poorly, lags and glitches will happen. I'm not saying old skin stock ROMs are bad, I actually like some. To install a good custom ROM onto your device, first you need to find one. So this is what you have to do. Go to forums.xdevelopers.com, then type in the name of your device here. It will take you to this page. From here, click on Android development, then click on ROMs. If your device isn't popular enough, it won't show up in the search bar. In that case, do a Google search like this: custom ROM followed by your phone model followed by site forums.xdevelopers.com. I will leave an example in the description, so it will be easy for you to just copy and paste it onto your search bar. I also want to say that XDA is not the only place from where you can download custom ROMs. There are actually a couple of awesome websites, but the reason why I recommend XDA is that 90% of custom ROMs are built by an XDA member, and if you face any issues while installing or after installing, there is a community to help you solve it. Selecting a custom ROM can be a pretty tough job, so read through the features and bugs reported by the users and download the one that you like. You could do the same for finding a custom kernel as well. Flashing a custom kernel isn't necessary because most ROMs already have kernel files in them. So if you flash a custom ROM, the kernel will also be installed onto your phone. Custom kernel has so many cool features such as soft partition, CPU overclock support, advanced color controls, and multi-ROM support. So read through the forum post and carefully select one kernel that you like and download the files. If you have downloaded the files using a PC, move the files to your phone. There are a couple of ways to install custom ROMs and custom kernels. The common way is by using custom recoveries. It is fairly simple these days to flash a custom ROM because new custom recoveries has a very simple UI. It doesn't matter which custom recovery you are using since all of them kind of have the same UI. Okay, now I will show you guys how to flash a custom ROM. Just reboot into recovery. If that sounds pretty complicated to you, then download an app called Reboot Recovery from the link in the description so you don't have to press and hold multiple buttons to get into recovery mode. When you see some fancy text and other UI elements, look for something similar to backup and restore. Tap on it and backup your current ROM because if something goes wrong, you can always restore. Before flashing a ROM, you should wipe all the cache and user data and system. So for that, look for something that says wipe, select that menu and wipe the cache, system and user data. You're basically factory setting your phone now. Sometimes you might need to wipe some other things too. Then look for something similar to install zip, tap on it, select the custom ROM zip file and just install it. If you want to flash a custom kernel, you must do it after you have installed the ROM, otherwise the custom kernel will get replaced by the kernel that comes with the custom ROM. To install a custom kernel, follow the same steps, that is, select the zip file and flash it, and then just restart your device. If you come across any problem, just go to the custom ROM's forum thread and report the problem that you had, and the developers will help you to solve it. If that problem persists, just restore your ROM back and try again with another ROM file. If everything goes well, you have a new device on your hand. The first thing that you want to do is make use of the features of the kernel and the ROM to enhance user experience. For example, if the custom kernel supports soft partition, use that feature to increase the RAM of your device. Little things like that can deliver a massive difference. You can also install apps like Reunify, Amplify, Ricebox to stop apps from running in the background. Now I have pretty much covered all the ways that I know to improve the performance and battery life of your smartphone. But if the phone that you're using is not that popular and don't have any custom ROMs available and it is not usable as a phone, So in that case, the best thing that you can do is use your smartphone as a security cam. It is actually pretty easy to set up. I will show it to you quickly. Download this app called IP Webcam from the Play Store. It is free. Make sure that you have connected your phone to your wireless router. Then open the app and tap on Start Server and then follow the instructions. It's pretty simple. Setting up your smartphone as a security cam is not a great solution and it is not reliable either. What I will do in this case is I will use that particular device as a test device for testing out different things, such as for testing different applications, for testing whether an app works on certain conditions and things like that. That's pretty much all I know about this topic. It was really difficult to make this video, so feel free to share this video with your friends and family and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And yeah, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Goodbye.